how to calculate midpoint. Welcome guys to another video tutorial from Knowledge's Form. In today's video, you would learn the midpoint formula and how to find the midpoint given two endpoints. We would also learn how to find one endpoint given the midpoint and another endpoint. Continue with this video because it's going to be very interesting. Some coordinate geometry questions may require you to find the midpoint of line segments in the coordinate plane. Now, to find a point that is halfway between two given points, you should always get the average of the x values and the average of the y values. Now let's take a look at this diagram. This diagram shows the midpoint formula for two points, okay, point A and point B. Now let's use the midpoint formula to calculate two points on the coordinate plane. Okay, now this is the midpoint formula. Okay, so now let's take an example here. Now this example says the midpoint of the point A and B is, so we have to find the midpoint. Now the first thing we're going to do is to write the formula. Always write the formula. The formula is this, is populated on the screen, shown on the screen. Now what do we do? Label your points. Okay, that's the ordered pair. 1 is x, 4 is y, 5 is x, 6 is y. So we are going to fix the values of the two endpoints into our formula, and then we're going to have this equal this. Okay, it is very simple. So we are going to perform the operation, and then we have 6 over 2 and 10 over 2. When you divide them, we are going to have 3 and 5 as the midpoint of the two endpoints. It is very easy. Now, how does one solve a missing endpoint when given the midpoint and another endpoint? I'm going to solve it with another question. This would explain vividly, very well, to us on how to find the missing endpoint when given midpoint and another endpoint. Okay, now let's take this question. The question here says M3 over 8 is the midpoint of line A and B, and we are given the points, the endpoint of A, but we do not have the point for B. Now, so B remains an unknown. Now, what do we do to an unknown number or unknown? We specify the unknown number or the unknown endpoint with what? A variable. And in this case, we are going to use W and M. W would be specified for X, and then M for what? Y. So we're going to use it to specify for the endpoint for line B. Okay, or for line AB, which is B. Okay, so from the formula, we are going to write it out. Okay, so this is from the formula, will be equal to 3 and 8 as the endpoint. Okay, so but we are looking for W and what? M. So what do? We are going to go ahead by solving them like this, and then we are going to cross multiply. So when you cross multiply, 3 multiplied by 2, it gives us minus 2 plus W equals to what? 6. So what are we going to do here? We are going to take this 2 to the other side, and then it becomes a positive number, leaving W equals to 8. Okay, so that is it, leaving W equals to what? 8. Now we're going to do the same thing to the other side, and then we're going to have 3 plus M all over 2 equals to what? 8. Okay, So what are we going to do? We're going to cross multiply 2 times 8, which will give us what? 16. And then you have 3 plus m equals to 16. So we're going to perform the same operation, taking this 3 to the other side, and then it becomes a minus. And then you have m equals to 13. And then you have the coordinates of the end point B is 8 and 13. Thank you very much.